I love this song. Daddy. Dream Daddy. Hang on, I have to pose for a thumbnail or whatever. Perfect! And let's just do this here. There we go. Hello! Where's Sis Cat?
Where the hell?
I don't know. Welcome, Dr. Dab! I knew a Dr. Dab once. Didn't last a minute in the operating room. You know what happened with Dr. Dab? Congratulations, Doctor, you saved the patient. Stupid. Ridiculous. I killed him myself. Just kidding. Well, not kidding, but over-exaggerating. Obviously, I didn't kill him, but I did kill his career. Uh-oh. John Verrill, have you tried... How do I put this delicately? Have you tried, fucking the pain away? Because this is the right place for that, sir. You've come to the right place. Because my friends, today on Dr. Soden MD, love turns... I'm not leaving until I get laid, because dammit, it's Friday night, and there's some dreamy daddies on this cul-de-sac. What do they call it, a cul-de-sac, anyway? Ugh, of course. No problem, AD. A little fighting warms the blood. How was that? Let me try again. A little fighting warms the blood. That's not bad. It's a great... Whoa! You could just give John a hand. Yeah, all right. Okay. John Verrill, I have certain techniques that have been known to aid in the... what's the word I'm looking for here? This music is so distracting, but I love it. I have some techniques that have been known to help discharge the burnitis in certain patients. If you'd like, I can show them to you. In my home. Perhaps with a glass of wine for a, to stimulate the conversation and the blood flow. Perhaps a little cheese. Some candles for warmth and light. Turn the lights down low so that you can't see what I'm doing. And then I can help you discharge your burneritis. It's all very professional. House call for Johnny Fuck Fuck. Yes, Kung Fu, I have. That's probably my favorite doctor-slash-surgeon fanfic. I love you, Love Turns. I do indeed. And, boy, hang on. Crosshair. This is a place of business and of medicine. This is a very serious place. So I have two things to say to you. One... Your puns are a little low. Let's bring the humor quotient up, please, the HQ. Two, it's time to play Guess What's in My Tea! Spoiler alert, it's not just tea. That's the hint as well. It's not just tea today. I am having a Christmas blend, but what is it blended with? I'll give you three guesses, chat. Cheese is wrong. You're wrong, the crosshair. That was one of your guesses. LSD is... LSD is also wrong. But I appreciate the sentence. Sometimes... Cocaine is also not... Oh my god, Love Turns. This is going to be a fabulous night. Welcome to the Dr. Surgeon MD. In the usual slot reserved for Panche. And I don't mean that as a euphemism. What's that mean? Today on Dr. Surgeon MD, I will be drinking my mystery tea concoction and trying to get laid here on the cul-de-sac, living with my daughter Amanda and a bunch of dreamy daddies. It's really fabulous. Ah! Crosshair, I meant as a chat of the whole. However, correct. There is some delicious whiskey in my tea. Mmm. Microdosing. No problem, Kung Fu. Actually, sorry, that is a problem, Kung Fu. I don't micro anything. I don't micromanage, and I do not microdose. It's macro or nothing. Go big or go to your death. That's my motto. One of them. I mean, obviously, if I had to list all my mottos, there wouldn't be enough room on my tombstone. All right, we should get into it because I get the feeling that this song on loop is probably bothering everyone except me. I love it. Please let me know if my sound levels are all right, other than the fact that I'm literally screaming into a microphone. I get very excited. It is a Canadian rye whiskey, or at least the kind I have is real rye whiskey. Delicious. Oh, little hit to the tea. Because that's the thing about tea. It's very flexible. Like my... You know what? Never. I'm not going to finish that sentence. Tea can be had in the morning as a wake-up call. In the afternoon as a pick-me-up. Or as a calming agent. And in the evening as a go-go party drink. It's flexible that way. It's just right for tea. Boo. Oh! Cheeks! You got a good burn on me! Also, welcome, Cheeky C. I'm very happy to have you here. See? I don't need to make fun of you in order to have a good time. Alright, okay. As have I, Cheeks. As have I. Let's jump into it. This is enough of this. Alrighty. Where the hell was it? Oh, God, that's right. Alright. To catch everybody up. Moving Pictures is... Best Rush album. Now that's comedy. Alright. Reminder. I went on a date with Damien because something about his gothic charm just excited me a little bit. Oh, Amanda's watch. Hang on. Alright. Sorry. She's sleeping. She's curled up. I'm just going to talk to you all for a second here. Let me know if the sounds are alright. That's what I like to see, Mr. Badmick. The date with Damien did not go very well. We helped bail his child out of a cask of Amontillado-style murder he was attempting at school. Murder. And I broke one of his gargoyles, Damien's. On the plus side, he wears a bitchin' cape. It's a really sort of a balanced kind of evening. Are you creamy? Woof. That is Yes, AD, that's what I like to see. Are there shots I should take for my burneritis? I'm sensitive to pain. I may not want to take a shot in the arm, so to speak. Right, all right. Yes, John Verrill, yes. If you want to go that route, I prefer sort of a tender kind of approach to burneritis, because sometimes just smacking it all at once can be a little shocking to the system. If that is the route you would like to take, yes, I can prescribe you... I can prescribe you a hot injection in the bottom, if that would do it for you. Charlie Charmander, welcome to the Dr. Surgeon MD. Dr. Surgeon MD's nuts. I'm done. I think we're done here. Let's see what's going on with Amanda. Yeah. Alright, yo. Alright, sorry. Here we go. Oh, boy. Amanda always watching that reality television. I love it! Couldn't have raised her any other way. Because there's something about fiction on... I don't really know what that means. What is that quote? Ugh. Oh yeah, the tiny house hunting brothers watch them with bemused expressions. Oh, that's pretty funny. Welcome to Charlie Charmander. Wow. Yeah. Sometimes you just gotta... I mean, I know it's Friday night and I'm ready to party, if you know what I mean, but sometimes you just have to live your life. Oh. She wants to know how afternoon tea went. It got strange. John Verrill. Boneritis is not terminal. Trust me. I am a survivor myself of boneritis. I had to use a few different techniques to handle the issue. But trust me, getting rid of boneritis is possible, if perhaps a little painful and a little time-consuming. I can definitely give you that hot injection between the cheeks, as it were, and we'll see if that helps. And if not, there are more extreme things we can prescribe. Wanna net hack and chill later? What the heck is a net hack? Alright, so, oh, sorry. What? Yes, someone's been reading. Yeah. Hang on. Wait a second. He live streamed a murder? There's too much. I can't get it. Thank you, Zen. Mucho apreciando. Damien Gaze, I was surprised I dig his style. Yeah, I sure do. Dad tip. Date complete. Alright, hang on. I'm very confused about what's happening here. B! Quite pleasant indeed. That's great. Great. No! John! Someone get down to Austin, Texas right away. It's a biggish city, but someone get there. Ask around for John Verrill. If they don't know who you're talking about, just say, the man from LARPs, he's got the boneritis. Just keep yelling it to the top of your lungs until you find him. Someone find him. Oh boy, I can't believe I'm saying this on live Twitch television. Take your hand, make it into a fist, all right? Turn him around, take down his trousers, and then reach around to the front of his body. Make that fist again. And do the Heimlich maneuver. That seems to help quite often. But hey, it works in the movies. Alright, I want to just speak about my scores here. Protective dad, clearly. Fang, I mean, it's a noun. I don't really understand. Victorian, of course. Basement, I mean, I like a good basement. Baby boomer. What the heck kind of... the heck kind of bar is that? No! John Verrill's dead! Alright. There's only one thing that can awaken him, and that's a kiss of true love. Or 10,000 volts, preferably with the kiss of true love on the side. Why would you get his trousers down? Good question, AD. It helps access the waist. The Amontillado? What the F is that? The cask of Amontillado, the crosshair. I pretended to not know the Edgar Allan Poe story. By the way, go read it. It's fabulous and horrifying. I pretended to not know about it so that Damien could teach me. Some people are into that. I'm more into the teaching and the cutting of other people. Right, of course. A B. B for boneritis. All right, here we go. The mail truck. Okay. You might have less chance to get cut by belt. Yeah, it's true. Ah, my coupons. I do like a good coupons. Oh, yeah, she's responding to Manda now instead of Amanda. She doesn't like the article A, you know? She wanted to be called The Manda, but it didn't really work out for me. Okay. Well... The Horn Institute for the Arts? Yes, I almost went there to study painting. The thing is, they didn't really like my portfolio. I wasn't a bad artist back in the day. I was just very avant-garde. You know, I wasn't very traditional. I thought it was called the Horn Institute for the Arts because people only painted with horns. Literally, they took a horn and dipped it in paint and used that to paint. So that's what I did. Made a whole portfolio that way. They were not impressed. and called my doodles childish and, quote, some of the worst work we've ever seen. Please don't bother coming back, Mr. MD. Scamander! I like that. Yeah, Thamander! Alright, okay. Hmm. Alright, let's see what's going on in here. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I wonder if she's getting into the school here. Oh. Hey! My daughter got into the Horn Institute for the Arts, and she didn't even have to make any horny artwork. I am so excited for her. Oh! That's all that can come out. Ah. Hey, oh, jeez, assist cat, get out of here! I'm trying to have a moment with my daughter. So much like Stargate. What the hell? Cross Salamander. Would you like a sketch I made of Sabrom, whatever his name? Yes, AD, I would. Assist cat, this is so not useful. I'm trying to hug my daughter. Oh, no, John Verrill, okay, alright. Look, I appreciate the messages from the grave. Someone get down there and give him those 10,000 juicy volts. No, my daughter is not hooking up with a daddy. They're all for me. My daddy's mine. Alright. Glad you're still dead. Not actually glad, of course, just I'm excited because then I get to, you know, bring you back from the dead and then I get to say, you know, ah, I'm the Jesus and he's Lazarus. You know, that sort of... okay, alright. It's expensive. It'll be tough, but we're gonna make it work. Don't worry, Amanda. I'm going to get a sugar daddy for us both. I mean, a daddy for you, a sugar daddy for me. Hey. Ah... All right, we're celebrating. Uh-oh. Burritos. Just give me a Rito with a view. Amanda, I love my daughter. Things I love about my daughter. Her artistry, her heart, her fashion sense, her sense of humor. Things I don't like about my daughter. Her damn obsession with shortening words. Burritos, not a word. It's a burrito. It's a very important burr at the beginning of that. You know? Yes, Kung Fu Fenris. I wasn't when I applied to medical school. I was just Mr. Surgeon MD back then. Give me a daddy wrapped in a tortilla. Let me look at it. Hashtag love dat view. Hashtag lettuce, tomato, and daddy. Not great. I can't say. Alright, okay. Alright. Whoa. Hang on, Amanda. Jeez Louise. You're not even there. Oh, that's very sweet. She's so excited. It's very sweet. Oh, that's a disaster. That's how I met Craig, you know. Made me take some bullshit, sir. Pardon my French. They made me say, take some sort of eight-ish. Eight-ish what? What does that mean? Ah, Cheeks, you were responding in the wrong chat again. I called it. Hashtag nailed it, I think. That's how I got matched with Craig, Amanda. You know... I filled out some sort of BS survey. What do you like most in a roommate? I said, British! What else do you like in a roommate? I said, no other factors! British. Openness to mottos. A good roommate can be a lifelong friend. Craig is Craig. Ooh. Oh, thank you very much, the crosshair. 15 cans. I'm really hoping it's cans full of money and not just empty ones that I have to recycle myself. I'm sorry. Thank you very much, the crosshair. Wait. Should be open. Check at the bottom of my page. Is there not a way to... Yeah, whatever. It doesn't matter. We didn't have a bad roommate. Ah, the puppy that Craig brought home. Yep, I remember that. It was very sweet. It was very sweet. Oh, I picked up my phone and it typed 8-ish. Flippin' cray cray. Doctor didn't nail anything. Hashtag nothing new there. Cheeks, let me tell you a little bit about the phrase nailed it. Obviously, three specific meanings for the term. Amanda, just give me a... I know you're talking about animals. You know, just hang out for a quick second. Three things that could be meant by nailed it. One, I got it right. Flashily and awesomely. Two, I literally took a nail and used a blunt force weapon to drive it into something. Three, I made sweet love to it. Much like putting a nail in something so hard and fast. I'm sorry, it's Friday night. Things are crazy today. Of those three, I have done all of them. And in fact, I've done all of them on the same night. Alright? You go over, you help someone put something up on the wall. You admire its artistry. And number three. So, don't tell me, Cheeks, that I don't know what I'm doing. Alright? Really? Okay, alright. I just need to be real for a second. You know, I had that talk with Mr. Vega. I'm sorry, the what? What? Wow! Of the three meanings, none of them applied to your statement. Hashtag dreams do not count. Hashtag never nailed anything. Cheeky C. For goodness sakes. In the name of the Queen, Queen Elizabeth II, long live our noble Queen. In the name of Queen Elizabeth II, Cheeky C, I obviously have done all of those things. One, I'm standing in front of my daughter right now, so clearly she's not adopted. Alright? Two, I understand none of them applied to the statement in that moment. I got excited. I'm sorry your phone just typed something. Jakes, you and I have a bantering relationship, and I appreciate that. But it hurts to be shown up all the time, you know? Especially by someone as awesome as you. It's like kicking a puppy. Or operating on someone when they can't fight back, you know? It's just not very nice. So I'd like you to remember that the next time we get into a little witty banter match. You know? Just lob me a softball. The line is Oh, Mr. Badmech! Oh, perfect, thank you, AD. I'll be checking that out in a moment. Mr. Badmech, you're thinking of the current version of God Save the Queen. I, of course, am thinking about the original, when I was a young boy. Tend her victorious, etc. No more out-of-turn remarks. Hey, Cheeks. Do you think they bought it? I think they bought it that I'm mad at you. Keep it up. I am certain you have a pair of softies already. It was fabulous, Cheeks. I'm a little furious. Fabulous. Fabulous. I'm so happy. Okay. Ooh. Oh, the paranormal occurrences. Aww. Sorry, I'm very proud of you. You're so grown up and a good person. You're so important to me. It's too late. It's happening. I got tears in my burrito. Tastes like the tears of children. So salty, but kind of sweet. Crosshair, it's sort of everything, really. The Empire's always under attack from everything. Where do you think the keep calm came from? Keep calm and make tea. Why would you need to keep calm? You say, it's just a normal Friday evening. Bam! Snake attack. Why would I need to keep calm? It's just a normal Monday morning. Bam! A lorry runs over your foot. It gets infected. Normally that would be fine, but you're in my hospital, and here we amputate, dammit. Sorry, Amanda, you're talking. Alright.
Welcome. You've got dads.
You've got dads indeed. Alright. Now here's the real question. If I want to get lucky, I would call Robert. I know he's ready, you know, he's just ready to go. Craig has a nice body. Brian is a piece of shit, and I'm not going to see him unless it's to ruin his life. No offense, Brian. He can't hear me. It's fine. Hugo. Joseph is a terrifying, evil person. And then there's Matt. What? Yes, AD, do you need me to look at it right now? I will. Coming up. Is that what you meant, AD? Because I'm going to look at it. Where is it here? I think I saw it, actually. Yeah. Ah, fabulous. Ooh. That little baby dragon is so sweet. It's so big. That's very sweet. Oh, don't forget the plan to steal Brian's corgi. Yes. That's... Ooh. Cheeks, that's very nice. Oh, I'm sure Kate is going to be very pleased. I have to ask. Alright, no polls. I just want an unofficial sort of reading the room here. Do we, one, go after Brian's corgi? Two, just try to get laid by any means necessary? Three, pursue the relationship with Darian? I obviously don't want to do that. Four, just go for the love of my life, that dreamy barista Matt. John Vero's back from the dead. Don't make any loud noises or you might startle him. John, can you hear me? It's the doctor, Surgeon MD. How are you feeling? Love always. Alright, Cheeks votes in. I like that. Yeah, it might be time. Maybe I'll have a couple dates with Matt, you know, see how they go, and then, get laid or get paid. It's what my mother said. Damn it, Veryl! Snap out of it! Doctor wants the D. Well, yeah, I mean, how else do you spell doctor? Can't spell doctor without the D. You also can't spell doctor without Octo! Aw. No, it's cute. I got inspired, drew staff, and that's what came out. Yeah, alright. We're gonna have a couple dates with Matt, and then, if things are going well, we'll pursue, and if not, we'll steal Brian's corgi. Here we go. I'm very excited. Matt Seller, avid music enthusiast, passionate coffee drinker. You can find me most days selling bean juice over at the Coffee Spoon or hanging out in the park with my amazing daughter. Hit me up about 80s no wave music. Okay, we're gonna have to work on a few things. A doctor, surgeon, octo, dad stream. Mr. Badmech, what the hell is an octo dad? Is that 8 dads that have been fused into some sort of horrifying being? If so, where can I get one? On Friday night, you are most likely to perfect my cold brew setup. If you had to take one thing on a desert island, fine tunes, legitimate, what are your turn-ons? Multi-instrumentalism? Matt doesn't know, but I'm a master of many instruments. The cutter, the poker, the piston-powered punchy, the tweezers, the saw, the laser. So excited. What's your favorite movie genre? Shit with subtitles. He obviously got bored. That's what I'm talking about, Crosshair, yes. Ideal date, animal shelter, and seriously consider adopting a cat. I already have two, Matt. You wouldn't have to go. Never leave home without headphones. Spend a lot of time thinking about where did writing commas into song titles come from? And where did it go? Did we all just agree that it's a bad idea? Yeah, the poker. Yeah, I agree, Cheeks. I think he might. Hello, Matt. Do you... How about that coffee? I don't know what to say to him. I'm so nervous. Alright, okay, here we go. Alright, let's try this. Hey, man. Great getting to see you at the Bibic. We should definitely hang soon. You're free later? Oh, I'd be down for that. I'm actually catching a show tonight at the Sound Garden. Boo. But I'll take it. Want to come out? Yeah, what's a sound garden? It's a concert venue, but also a band. Bubbuck. Another message pops up. Pop is playing tonight. A little indie pop punk rock band. I can't speak. Hang on, let me try that. Cool little indie pop punk rock band out of Canada. Should be a fun one. Yeah, I know, Rock Pants, I know. Shit with subtitles, it's my Psy cover band. I like to hear that, Kate. When was the last time I went to a concert? Psy is day back. Mullet... 80s prog rock. Okay, alright, so I haven't been to a concert in a long time. What do you even do at concerts? Do you just jump around, or... I mean... I always thought I was cool. Mullet. Lo, what are your thoughts on mullets? I want an opinion from a dad such as yourself. Alright, sorry, here we go. Dad, what are you... what? Nothing. Hey, how do I be cool? Wow, Amanda, what a biatch. That's not very nice. You took me when I was 12. Suddenly overwhelmed by a sea of screaming You also jump up, and get down at concerts. Yeah, practical and stylish. Not the answer I was expecting, Lo. I'm intrigued. Show your work. Cheeky C? Excellent. That's what I like to hear. I'm a big fan of jumping up, and then before touching the ground, jumping up again before getting down. That's the double jump. It's really very exciting. Alright, sorry. What were you... Oh, God. Dad, look, I mean, who didn't, Rock Pants? Let's be real here. It's not even a shame to... You're not ashamed? Alright. Yeah, well... Oh my, Amanda, what do you... Yeah! Ah, Vector Wegg! Hello, Vector Wegg. Welcome to the Dr. Surgeon MD. They're a punk band? Like DIY gutter punk, thrash, straight edge? Jeremy? What's Jeremy? Hey, good one, Amanda. Yeah, go everyone, get on. How do you double jump? AD Sassery, it's very simple. You jump, and then before that you hit the ground, you say to yourself, by God, I'm British, I can do this better, and you jump again. Scientifically, you use the little cushion of air that you've created by starting to land on the ground to push off of, using your knees. Sorry, Amanda, you're talking. They're Canadian? Where's Amanda's mom? yeah. Cheeks, yes. Trisha 1.0 is as good as dead. Nothing wrong with Trisha 1.0. I mean, lots of things wrong with our relationship, of course, but nothing wrong with her. But, that's where she is. Does the idea of Canadian punk seem contradictory to you? I mean, not really sure. Okay, I like that. That's funny. That's right, RJ. So where did Amanda get her fabulous hair? The length from her mother, the color from me, clearly. Hashtag Trisha lives. Yeah, I know, John. She's dead to me. God damn it. Ugh. Well, what I wouldn't give to see her again. She'd be so proud of her daughter. I would hope. And I will. If a strange dude in a sexual girl's hoodie offers to buy you merch, don't accept it. Oh, no. Oh, Amanda. What? Never mind, just have a blast. I don't know what you mean, Cheeks. Not what you mean by color. Ah. Hey, you made it. Wow. Man. He is fabulous. Oh, excellent work, everyone. Sorry for the people who didn't make it. Ready? I was born ready. I sleep with one eye open. Prepare to kill. Are you? Ugh. Ah, man. I've been to a real concert since Pet Rocks were cool. Oh, God. Hang on. I have to... Yikes. Yes. You're damn right. Sorry, man. I'm off on a... Ay, ay, ay. I'm off to a rocky start here. Just hang with me, Doctor. You'll be good. Okay, great. What is scene? Yeah, I know, John. I know. That's what all the cool dads are calling it these days. They're more like... It's good to see you up and about, John Verrill. I don't know what happened. You were gasping for air a few minutes ago, and anyway... Okay, interesting. Oh, the middle distance. It's, yeah. Oh, okay, Matt. Let's head to the show. Sure. I'm sorry again, Matt. Oh, dear. I think I said the wrong thing there at the start. My waning youth is showing... Ooh, better tuck that back in. I'm suddenly aware of my mortality. Whoops, put that under the hat. When were the good years of my life... Will she still love me? Wait, is CM Punk Matt, you made it. Oh. Me too. I mean, who is that? Ah, Dev! Welcome. You're just in time for my first date with the love of my life. I assume. Oh, that's nice. Matt knows everybody. Oh, that's fabulous. I'm so afraid of all these people. What? Oh, let's go grab a beer. Okay. Yeah, let's hang out at the back. That's where we all like it. In the back. You know what I mean? Hey. Yeah, you got a lot of shows. Hey. Oh, yeah, Matt. I, of course, don't have that problem. Running out of things to say to seem charming and funny after 5 minutes, I don't have that problem. But I understand most normal people do. And then, yeah. I also am always keenly aware of where my hands are. They're right here! Don't worry, everyone. They're right- Whoa! It's right here, don't worry. I got on this one, too! It's fine. Put it in the hole, tiger. John, please. I'm a gentleman. And a doctor. I hold a doctorate. A PhD. Some people would call it a doctorate degree in cutting things open and sewing them back up. I prefer to think of it as higher education. But we do not just put it in the hole, tiger. Except in certain kinds of surgeries where you're trying to thread something through a small hole, clearly. Alright, sorry, Matt. Yeah, exactly, RJ. You need a reason. Oh, it's an expression derived from golf that means achieve your ultimate goal. Oh, great. Yeah, Cheeks. I get that. Hands in the rock pants. Oh my god. We don't just put it in the hole. Yep. Yeah. Oh, that's nice. Just you wait. This scene seems really friendly. I don't know why people wouldn't want to admit that they listen. Let's check out the merch. Oh, God. Sorry, excuse me. He's so crusty. I can smell the crust coming off of him. Look at this. Low-rise pants and a crop top. With that hair. Oh my god. And your earlobes. I understand Matt is into some cool stuff, but this is ridiculous. If you took those out of your ears, those gauges, they would just be flopping around. Same thing with your crop top. Your belly's just flopping around. V deeper than the Mennonites.
Ooh.
19.11. Not sure what you mean, Kung Fu, but yes, I would give this teenager a 19.11 out of 100 as well. Get your merch. I got t-shirts, tank tops, gifts, and accoutrements. Oh, yeah. You smell it. What? No, that's... Tally-ho! Well, see here, fine shopkeep, your enthusiastic salesmanship has aroused my interest and suspicion in equal parts. How can I, a consumer of the finer goods in life, trust your wares to be true of spirit? A fine question from a discerning patron. Okay, Pablo, chill the fuck out. Yeah. Give him the old razzle-dazzle. Yeah, spot on. You're damn straight, Kung Fu. As if I would say it that way. Day by day, my man. They do that thing, but they high-five into a hug. You know, you grab the hand and then you don't let go and you bring it in. Your mom? Wait. Whoa, what? No, it's not... That's sweet, but no. How about Tally No? John Verrill, these two have not smashed. I am 100% certain. He's talking about his mother. John Verrill, what are your thoughts on debris fields of previous smash-pocalypse, smash-pocalize? That makes sense to me. My mother's still single. Oh, I know. I left her that way after you were born. You know, yes, I buy that. They look pretty close in age, though. John Verrill, what are your thoughts on debris fields? Do you, you know, take it slow and kind of avoid the various asteroids, or are you just full steam ahead, ramming speed, Captain? What are your thoughts? Is Dr. Cool? Hey. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's what I like to hear. Oh, that's disgusting, Jonathan. Jonathan Erasmus Verrill, that's horrifying. Ah, oh yeah. Yep, the old two pats on the back. It's a classic. Kid plays the hell out of a bass. How do you play the hell out of a bass? Three-way back on the table. Oh boy. Witch house. Ugh. It's a shame! You know, cross-cross, vacant, with the A's replaced by triangles, veil, cross-cross, would have slayed. Pablo, I don't say this very often, but I'd like to rearrange the inside of your head. All that. Shirts are really nice. Oh, yeah, sure, Matt. All right, we'll be back in a sec. Yeah, exactly. Impact in the nether regions. Just sent my first... AD. Excellent. All right, sorry. Band, strange instruments, a harpsichord. Oh, a mandolin. Oh, no. Jonathan Jones and the Speakeasy Choir. Oh, it's one of those indie groups. Oh, ha. I only like one type of music. And that's marching bands extolling the virtue of my empire. You know what I mean? That's, oh god. Oh no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want everyone to be able to hear this. Fabulous. Fabulous, that was wonderful. No, Dev, don't, come on. You know I don't want to fight you. Mostly because I'm not sure if I'd win. Hopsa-chick-a-ta. Thanks! What actual? Agreed, Cheeks. I couldn't have put it better myself. Wow. Is this a Yoko Ono tribute? Rock Pants, I can only assume. One of my favorite things I've ever seen was the secret Beatles concert in the early 70s with a Yoko Ono opener. It was truly night and day. The first, a beautiful artistic performance interpreting the classics in a new and exciting way. Not melodic so much as harmonic and dissonant. The other was the Beatles. I'm sorry, we should. There's no breaks. Oh God. Do you go to a lot of concerts? Do you go to a lot of concerts? No, we're dropping it. A lack of tubescence? Shit, John Verrill, we have to... What do you mean, AD? What do you mean, how am I British? There's only one way to be British. The right way. Not really sure what you mean. Oh, God. Woof. Oh, I have a lot of questions. Yeah. Oh. What the hell? Let's get another. Yeah, exactly, Kung Fu. I'm confused. Everyone's confused. It's like Maybelline. Maybe he's born with it. Or maybe he's just British, you know? More and more people. Well, it's getting kind of crowded. Careful, Dr. Surgeon. We def have some lefty British too. I'm not sure what you mean by lefty. AD, what the hell does that mean? What is British British versus just British? Cheeks, do you want to, can you edify me, please? I'm very confused about what AD means. If you mean, am I from the British Isles? Yes, the Doctor Surgeon MD is from the British Isles. Where exactly? I don't want to talk about it. ADA, there are so many different British target lock lost. No shit, John Verrill. Oh God. Stay on course, Mr. Verrill. Hard to starboard. What if I'm trapped? No, Dr. Surgeon, it's fine. Oh, it's Matt. Oh, phew. Thank you for grabbing me with your strong arms. I mean... Red 5, standing by. Here we go. Capital B, British. Yeah, good. Oh, I'm blushing. Oh, Matt, your big strong arms. They're covered in tattoos and delicious. Ugh. John Verrill, disgusting. I mean, look, whatever helps him get rid of that boneritis. Am I right, folks? Hey, Bellandora, you made it with a quote, no less. Good to see you. Unless you're lurking, in which case... You do you. Pop brings out a crowd. Mm-hmm. I think it's one thing to listen to music and connect, but when you're in a room full of people connecting, that's magic. Wow. Delicious. Crosshair, I'm not sure what would be confusing about a nun in a revolving whorehouse. It's very simple. There are people who are prostituting themselves for money, and they go around. Being a nun has nothing to do with it. Hey, Bellandora. Oh, sorry. My tiny dad bladder. Yes, you are beautiful. I mean, it is beautiful. I have to go pee. I sure you do, John Verrill. Okay, I'm running. I'm going. Oh, that's nice. Oh, shoot. Oh, God, get back there. How am I going to find Matt? We have to find Matt. Okay, I gotta find him before I get trampled by all these rowdy youths. Uh-oh. Okay, come on, come on. Oh god. Come on, we're going. Let's go find our mat. Is that him? Is that you? Is that you, Matt? Whoa! Well, this is fun. So many people moshing about in this incredibly long hallway. Why is this hallway so damn long? Ow! Stop bumping into me! Oh god, they're coming. The youths! Youthquake! Ah, it's coming! Youthquake! Go, Doctor! God, how long is this cafe? This can't possibly be up to code. Although, this is not half bad musically. Oh, shoot, ow, excuse me, sir. Coming through. Ow. I'm going, hop. This is the only way to get through crowds, by hopping. Nice work, Doctor. Ow. Come on. Yes. Like a golf pencil in a mineshaft. Ow. God damn it. Ow. Come on. 30 seconds. Oh, they're coming. We're doing great. It's coming, Youthquake. Ow. Ow. Oh, shoot. No. Did I fail? Aw. Yeah, I know, Crosshair. It's really... I thought you'd be used to long hallways. I am! John Verrill. I was so close! Yeah, it was horrible, Cheeks. The hallway. Not the music. The music was fine. Man, I wish Matt were here. Oh no. Hey. Wasn't it a great show? Totally. Would have been more fun with you. Yeah. Hey. Am I hungry? Yes, sure. Are you cooking? Oh, it's a tiny little diner. I don't know. Bacon and eggs. Breakfast of champions, especially at night. Assist Cat, I swear to God, nobody invited you. You're very cute, though. Hello? Alright, I think we're fine. Yeah, it was very sweet, Belindor, I agree. Not from the tattoo. Shall I send pizza to the P.O. box? AD, I don't know. I mean, is there someone living in the P.O. box who can eat said pizza? Otherwise... what the hell's going to happen? They're just going to deliver and go, this is a P.O. box, we don't deliver here, and then they're going to throw it away. Maybe eat it themselves, sadly. Or happily, I don't know. Damn it, this is outside my area of expertise. Human insides, human outsides, and human emotions. Those are my areas of expertise. Oh, sorry. Good work, Matt. Oh, that's nice. Glad you worked it out. Punk's not dead. It just drives a minivan and has to hire a babysitter. That's sweet. Ooh. That's cool, Matt. What did you play? The pizza would become from normal pizza over time to mushroom pizza. It's true, AD. That is how that works. Right. Sorry, Matt. You were saying. How are your bacon and eggs? You're talking. I'm sorry. Yes. Community is important. I agree. Especially that Pablo. Ah, that's sweet. Yeah, his mum's been raising him on her own. After I... never mind, you know what, that's fine. That's really nice, yeah. It is really nice of you, Matt. Matt, I want to talk to you about surgery. Should we talk... Carmen Sita. That's sweet. Oh boy. All my daughter's hobbies are super quiet. Photography, collaging, you know, taking photos, cutting things up and putting them together. Internet-ing. Good work, Amanda. Well done. Yeah, it's true, Matt. But you're just so cool. Lurking. Commenting. Posting cat memes. Whatever that means. Mimes. Like what? Oh god, what did he say? Oh god. Alright, hang on. He said, you should find something to do together. Not big budget remakes of foreign films. Are we rebellion? Oh, rebelling. We're definitely rebelling against big budget remakes of foreign films. Yes. Yes. Breakfast for dinner. Oh, I see, AD. No problem. I can save you. Your chest is pounding, someone stole your heart. Step 1, get your heart back. Step 2, go to a hospital. Step 3, get the doctor to put it back inside you. If step 1 doesn't work, proceed directly to step 2. And step 3, instead of getting them to put it inside you, just get them to take someone else's and put it inside you. Dr. Surgeon, 3 easy steps. Yes, it is a lonely feeling. Matt, I wouldn't want you to feel alone. Get nervous. That's just so cool. I never really considered myself an extrovert or an introvert. I'm just kind of flirt more. Yes. Oh, that's sweet, Matt. That's very nice. I'm sorry I couldn't get you. I was about 10 seconds away before I got overpowered by those stupid children. The hell is that sound? Excuse me, hang on. This is cats. Just a second, Matt.
Hello? Cat? Maybe
it
shouldn't be over there, huh?
Stupid. Get someone else's and put it inside you. Wowie Maui. Ah, tonight was a blast, Matt. I could get lost in those eyes. I'm probably gonna feel it in my knees in the morning. Wouldn't mind feeling something else in my knees in the morning. What? Yeah, it was really cool to have you there. All right, Matt. Matt called me cool. Hey, Amanda. Matt thinks I'm cool. AD, great question. Scott, my social media manager, he explained this to me once. There are shirts, sort of a shirt-like garment for animals, called Thunder Shirts. They have other names as well. That's a brand name. If you wrap an animal in them, they calm down. Provide stimulation to their sides, like a hug. Animals typically react quite positively to that. So it's to keep them calm. Doesn't seem to be working terribly well. tea time. I hope everyone has their drink of choice for tonight's party. Whoops. Uh-oh, the old double quote. Just got dunked on by my own child. Unbelievable. Yeah, right, Amanda. Hope you wake up with all your organs. Oh, good, Dev. I'm glad to hear it. Wish I had an iced coffee. Just give. How did I do with Matt? See. Wasn't the best, but it wasn't the worst. Oh, my band puns, scar, coffee, and worthwhile hobby are all down. Crowd surf and cell phone holster are up. Ugh, disgusting. Oh. Dad points, daddy points. Aren't those the same? I'm very confused. Oh, a C. C is for cool, Rock Pants. Yeah, maybe that's how he feels about me. Damn it, I really need to pick it up. You know what I'm gonna do? You've got dads. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to practice our smooth moves. Oh. I don't know why. Try a quote edit, maybe? Have you been trying? Quote edit. Oh, you're trying, I see. I don't know, Mr. Badmech. Have a look at that, sorry. Alright, here's the deal. We're gonna try a date with one of the other dads just to get a sense of how best to flirt. And then we'll go back to Matt. Oh, jeez, Crosshair, you're right. Okay, you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna go for my old friend Craig. Juggling work for... Oh, God. On Friday night, he's most likely to get a cardio section in. Energy bars, a turn-ons, or a sub-6-minute mile. Be upon buddy cop movies. Scaling a huge, dangerous mountain. My mile time? Oh, never mind. I can't. Ugh. Go for Robert. You know you want to. Mr. Badmech, you're not wrong. He basically offered to sleep with me the first time we met. Wow. Alright. Robert Small. Only people named Small would be confident enough to keep their name Small. He would have changed his name away from Small if he weren't confident. That's what I like to hear. Sorry. When the internet gains sentience and strives to destroy us all, you know it'll use this information against us, right? Wow, okay, this is fabulous. Alright. On a Friday night, you're most likely to make a deal in an alleyway, have it go badly. Who's the cop? Was it Yakomo? I trusted Yakomo. If you had to take one thing with you onto a deserted island, gun. What did you want to be when you grow up? Grifter. What are your turn-ons? Don't talk to me. What's your favorite movie genre? Italian neo-realism. Chris O'Hare is fabulous. Crosshair, would you go with Chris O'Hare? Never leave home without at least 4 knives. Grave robbing is an ideal date. For God's sakes. He's horrifying, but... I mean, at least he might put out, right? Ugh, God, Robert. Ugh. I guess I have to... Oh! Adia's lawyer. I totally missed you. Don't go with him! Too late, AD. I gotta get me some dad. Some strange dad. Heh. Ruggedly handsome. God. Hey, Robert. Good seeing you again at the cookout. Want to grab a drink? Well, I mean, I do like a good cat video. Nope. Oh, yikes, Kung Fu. I mean, the History Channel is a favorite of mine. I suppose I should do that. Naked and Afraid, Catching the Deadliest Ancient Aliens. Oh, no. Ancient astronaut theorists predict that being naked makes you 10 times more likely to find ancient aliens. Alright, back in. Time for old Chef Surgeon MD to cook up a gourmet delicacy. Oh! Microwave eggs, mustard jar. Oh my god, this is disgusting. Sandwich. The Standwich. Yes, sir. Oh no, I dropped it. No! Still good. 5-second rule. Reassemble. Yeah. Nuka eggs. Disgusting. An old basketball hoop. Ready to dunk. Oh god. Ah! The emerald! Welcome! We're having a good time. I'm just waiting for Robert to message me back. What is he, too good for Dr. Surgeon MD? Not possible. Something something Space Jam. Oh, that's good. Carton of ice cream. Chopped toddler tournament. This is literally a jar of baby food. Yes. Egg, ham, and cheese in a Nuka Sturdy cup. High on 2 minutes, and done. Cup o' omelette. Dr. McDreamy, come on and slam! And welcome to the gym! I mean, the fact that I'm playing basketball alone in my home, that's a little unfortunate. Oh, my computer! What's that? What was that ding? Hi. What are you doing? Ugh, can't even use full words. Oh, should I lie about owning a motorcycle? He'd probably be into that. And here begins the Dr. Surgeon MD's deadly decline into deceit. Also known as DDD. It's all I ever think about is D's. Am I going to lie to Robert just to get in his weird cargo pants? I don't... God. What the hell, Emerald? No, I did not know that. Crosshair, you must. It's awful. You must. Awful and fabulous. John Verrill would... I don't know if he'd agree with me or not. Weigh in, folks. Weigh in. Why Amanda is the adult? Great question, AD. It's because, as a father, I am the adult. But she knows what she's doing in terms of Dream Daddy D, right? Yeah, I guess... Well... Let's try lying, I suppose. Just working on my motorcycle. Dad, you're spinning a web of lies. You bet. You have never been on a You've never been on a motorcycle in your life. I don't even think you ever touched a motorcycle. Nice try, though. Yeah. Wanna grab a drink? I know what it means, Amanda. Excuse me, Mr. Badmech, I have the emotional maturity of Gello Plus. Thank you very much. It's kinda late. I'm a little tired. There's some banging happening outside my home. It's a little scary. Hello? I think it's fine. I hear some rusty squeaking. I'm sure it's fine. Fine. Oh, well, going to Jim and Kim's. Yes. Hello, Robert. How's it going? Hey. Ahoy, Skipper. Oh, God. Oh. I brought Mary along. Figured we needed a drinking buddy. Robert! What the hell? Oh. Exactly, Crosshair. And no, Rock Pants. I mean, maybe I should. The banging seems to have stopped. Nor do I hear any squeaking. Those are probably good signs. Nothing. Alright. No, Mr. Badmech, look, this is not the threesome I would have anticipated. That said... Yeah, I agree, Zen. Boo indeed. Who the fuck is Mary? Kung Fu, Mary is the wife of Joseph. I think they might be in a very strange... Yeah, I agree, Zen. It's very odd. I think Verrill set this up. Yeah. Yeah, Lo, I have to tell you. She's... Good lord, AD. She's married to Joseph. Now, I imagine that they live kind of separate lives here. Oh, sorry. We're just having a drink. What are you having? Whiskey. Whoa! Got all those eggplants coming out of the butt. He must be carrying a whole bunch under his coat. Here's to bad decisions and relaxed moral values. Oh, God. I don't believe she believes in the sanctity of marriage. Dev, I don't know what could have possibly given you that idea. Holy hell. Ugh. Oh no, Bellandora, it's true. What? We're bar hopping? Alright. Oh god. Oh, ADIC, alright, that's not what I thought. Okay. So where are we headed? I'd wish I were drinking. Puns are the lowest form of humor, Doctor. Try harder. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, put your fangs away. Yeah, I agree, Rock Pants. Why the hell is Mary even here? It's really horrifying. Do they make fruity Irish cocktails? Doctor, if you want to do this right, you're going to get this right. Whiskey hasn't done me wrong yet. No, no, we're fine, Zen. It was just... To be honest, Zen, we actually have new neighbors. My neighbor vacated the place next to me. Move across the hall to someone with more light. So we have a new, people next door. I haven't met them yet, though. I'm just hoping this isn't my first impression, hearing me yelling about eggplants, Britain, and tea. Get the bat. Mary's an alky. Look at her hand. Oh, God. Whiskey. Oh, God. Let's sip this one, why don't we? Suit yourself. Boom. Hey. I bet it would. Oh, it's true, AD. Good point. Hello, everyone in the chat. Welcome to the Dr. Surgeon MD Finding Love Edition, Episode 3. If you are new here in chat, please raise your hand. If you live near the Dr. Surgeon, please raise your hand. I don't think they're here, Eddie. Hey, that's my drink. Mary. Why is she even here? Oh. Good work, everybody. As I head back, I see them having a lively conversation. Oh, God. Oh, God. Pot brownies. Gremlin. Yeah. You're ruining the bake sale, she says. Whoa, AD, you're the new neighbor! Well, come on over, AD. We'll have a party. Come on in. Your roots are bad, blah, blah. I told you to have a brownie, and everything was going to be... Step off, Doc's man, Mary. What? What? Step off. Step off Doc's man, Mary. The importance of commas, the Emerald. A comma allows a brief pause. It separates clauses in a sentence. It also allows you to process the meaning. Step off Doc, man, Mary. You know, that's very different. She ate three. Ha ha ha. Well, that's very funny. Do you smoke weed? Hey. What? The devil's lettuce. I have two big fat blunts in my purse right now. Wanna blaze? Alright. Alright. I am not feeling this right now. I gotta tell you, I really wanted this to just be Robert and I have a drink, pretend to like his jacket and his glasses on his deep V, maybe his chest hair, and just get some action for the stream. That's what I wanted this to be. And now they're talking about smoking pot. No, what? I am a law-abiding citizen. Oh. Robert liked that. Well, yeah, it's true, eh, Rock Pants? That's a good point. Then I am a super law-abiding citizen. I'm just kidding, cowboy.
Hey.
Okay, all right. Mary's fine. I just wanted some time with Robert, you know? You with the feds. How do I get Mary to leave? Popcorn. How do I get Mary to leave? Oh, I don't... I think he's just got his hand... It's a good point. Bill and Dora, I hadn't noticed. I should not bring up Joseph. I'm sure that's not going to go well. Maybe I'll send her off on a wild goose chase. Oh. Wow, Mary. Wow. What the hell? Of course I'm trying to freaking ditch you. You're cock-blocking me. Also known as the C-block in surgery. We use it, I mean, really, it's a metal sheet that we use to sort of block the patient's nether regions. You know, it's sort of a privacy shield. But I prefer the C-block. No, it's fine. Doctor wants alone time with his new best buddy, Robert.
Hey.
Mary needs to sink her teeth into a helpless boy. Good lord. Mary! Mary, what the hell? You're married! I'm so confused. Does she, though? Alright, Robert. Yeah, thank you, Rockpants. You know, they're married. Yeah, exactly, Crosshair. I mean, I guess I shouldn't have just, you know, done that, but... She's harmless? I don't believe that. Hey, I got him to laugh. That's good. Do you know I pegged you for one of those straight-laced types? I prefer my lace not straight. Curved, stretched, twirly. I don't, you know, I got pretty wild back in my day. Still got a little... still got a little wild in you. I have a child I need to care for. There's so much wild in me. I get so wild, I've got a whole safari in here. Just freely. I like my laces crisscrossed. Uh-huh. Oh, this is not going well at all. Dr. Surgeon is not doing well in the love department. Think you could go shot for shot? I mean, I'm going to try. That's one. So, how are things? I hate small talk. Okay. You're bombing! Yeah, I know, Kung Fu, I know. It's not going well, all right. Yeah. If you want some unsolicited advice, learn to be comfortable with silence. I am, Robert C. Comfortable with silence! Okay, you just want to sit here and drink whiskey in silence. Ugh. Yeah, I guess. Okay, AD. There it is. There it is, Crosshair. I like that. Now, AD, you do you. We're having a good time here. You stay up as late as you like, young friend. You know. Watch the life drain from someone. No, Robert, he's joking. No. Great, me neither. Or am I? Ha ha ha! I mean, maybe Robert's not so bad. You ever watch someone die? Yes. What? Gosh, this whiskey's hitting me hard. Oh my, let's roll. Whiskey, inside voices. Let's row. What about Mary? Okay. Oh, boy. Well, it's a good point, Crosshair. I technically haven't killed anyone. I've watched the life drain from their eyes in front of me, but it was not my fault. Legally speaking. Oh, God. Where to? You'll see. A rundown strip mall. A beauty salon. Assist cat, buddy, I'm trying to be on a date. A sex shop, a computer repair store, and a liquor store. Oh, God. Of course. White Zinfandel? Well, no, nothing. I was just. Yeah, I know, Crosshair, definitely. Let's throw rocks at shit. What? No, oh, for God's sakes, Robert. No, I don't. No. I got a problem with authority. That's what I'm talking about. Really? Oh no! I didn't mean to do that. Oh, I wouldn't want to do that. Oh no. Oh, assist cat, not now, buddy. Maybe we strike that from the to-do list. Let's get pizza. Yes, sir. I just need to be edible and in my mouth in 5 minutes. Robert, you know what to do. Oh my goodness. Pizza. No, cat. For God's sake. Oh, for floof sec. Pizza. Yeah, sure. Can I get 2 slices of Hawaiian? Oh. Oh, all right. I'm going to say, of course, just for Robert. But otherwise, citrus on pizza, it's not a thing. All right. Giant slice on a... Rest of that sentence was unnecessary. Greed, then. Take our pizzas. Yeah, it's delicious. Mm. Pineapple is truly the best pizza topping. Okay. Mm. You and me both. Mm. What? I mean, I should make sure my daughter's all right, but I really want some of Robert. Oh god, those eggplants, get them out of here. Cat, buddy. Okay. It's completely dark. Ooh, what's in here? An old movie theater. Yeah, take one for the team, eh? No, there's nothing wrong with it, Mr. Badmack. It's just not natural, you know? Don't shush me so loud. Shush! Oh. Oh, good. It's still a movie. All right. Yeah, I agree, Zen. It's horrifying to see them coming out of his jacket like that. I don't know where he's keeping them all. Kiss already. Hey, man. Keep it down. Oh, God, no. It's him. Oh, no. It's Ernest Hemingway. Never thought I'd say those words. Kidding. I say them every day. Wake up. I look at my bookshelf. I go, oh, no. It's Ernest Hemingway again. Oh, it turns out he did. Sorry, I'm just... you know, I can narrate the movie as well as anyone here. The point is that, you know... Love is dead. Shut up, it's beautiful! No, you shut up. Whoa! Hundreds of people worked very hard to make this film happen. You're gonna sit here and appreciate them. Okay... Thank you, Elizabeth Shelton. Ernest and Amanda hooking up. Mr. Badmack, if they are, I will be getting Katatha out. And I can't say what I'm going to do with her. Suffice it to say, Ernest Hemingway might need to find a new profession. Peter Anders. Alright, okay. Yeah, we stumble into the parking lot, our wine. Hey, assholes! Oh, my knee! Oh no, some kids! What are we going to do, Robert? Oh, what you guys want? This is my good knee. You ruined my theater-going experience. Now, you have to pay. Oh. I don't have any cash on me. Ow! We ruined it for you? Hey, no fighting. Robert, you're a grown man and that's a child. This is awful. Stab the fucker! Mr. Badmack. I like that. Assist cat, I hear you. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Alright, that's fine. No, you listen. That popcorn ass drivel the mass media is shoving down your throat. Will make you dumber and sadder. Yeah, I agree, Rock Pants. He's trying his hardest. Oh, no. Oh, my God. My knee. Fuck. My knee. Talk like punk. Get hit like a punk. Oh, God. Queensbury rules. 3 minute rounds with 1 minute rests in between. No low blows, fish hooks, great J grabs, or high blows. Alright. I want to de-escalate this. If only because, frankly, Robert is not worth it. I'm going to get in a lot of trouble with Mr. Vega. I... Oh god. I don't want to get dragged into this. That movie sucked. Too late! You're bloodbound. Just boxes here. We'll do, Zen.
How dare you.
We're just gonna go. Oh, thank God. Mm. Good work, Robbie. Robbie. You know what? Screw it. Let's call him Robbie. Good work, Robbie. Consume better content. Pugilism rules. Such poetry. Were you about to fight that kid? Good job, Robert. Oh my God, the emerald, no. Full disclosure, that's not real. Oh, bye, assist cat. Okay, bye, Robert. Oh boy. It's okay. Which half? Half of what, the emerald? What the heck? What is happening, people? Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, no. Now Robert's talking about old films. Thanks for the adventure. Yeah, oh, yeah. His little hearts. Oh, that's lovely. This was an interesting night. I liked it. Let's hang again soon, yeah? What, you gonna invite me in or what? Huh? Excuse me? Can't just sleep with me on the first night? That's a lot of dad points. Wow. I mean, guess I can't complain. Damn it, I don't like Robert, though. Damn it.
Welcome. You've got dads.
You've got dads indeed. Alright, I gotta get back to Matt. Oh, Joseph. Ugh. Maybe if I go on a date with Craig, he'll let me see that rockin' bod. But then again, it's Craig. Ugh. If I go on a date with... Yeah, I know, Kung Fu. I'm shocked and kind of frankly disgusted. I don't want to talk to Robert again. A for disappointing. Alright. I really don't want to try the corgi stealing thing. A for almost. Yeah, exactly. A, if you loop around back to the end, it's F and then D. So A is almost F to the D. That's what I like to think. Alright. A for. Oh my God. A for what you two will do on your next date. Let's hit up Craig. The Emerald, I think that's my best bet. Look, I definitely don't want to have a date with each of these dads. Frankly, some of them are horrifying. Joseph clearly is a monster. Hugo named his child Ernest Hemingway. Brian's probably not that bad, but he's so smug about his little girl. Ugh. You know, after A comes S, and S stands for Sassore? Sasori? Not sure. Alright. I don't think I'm going to like... Craig's probably going to propose going for a run and then climbing a mountain while holding an oxygen tank on your back. But... Oh, Craig. Let's do it, I guess. Here we go. Ah, smash! It stands for smash! Kung Fu... No. We're getting some if my life depends on it. Hey, Craig, or should I say neighbor, neighbro, do I get a cookie? Yes. Might be a bit different from our weekend-long benders. All right. Oh, good. What the hell? No. Oh, no. Oh. Hello, Amanda. What you working on? Neighbro! Yes, definitely, Crosshair. It's pretty good. Our goals for the future. Huh? It's a lot of dogs. Did you need something?
Oh, no.
Yes, Amanda, I remember that very specifically. You hid in the dugout and you would scream if I tried to pick you up. Cat! Assist cat! Get the hell out of here. Let me know if I get muted on anything. So you don't want to go.
Aww.
I'm gonna face my fears! Good work, Amanda! Excellent. Neighborhood. Ah, good point, the Emerald. Excellent. Of course, yes. Well, I wouldn't want him keeping the baby on him while we got down and dirty. AD, we have two cats, assist cats here, Ella and Ripley. Named after two of the deadliest women of fiction. Ripley, Ellen Ripley, and Ella. You know, Ella. You know, like, you see her coming and you go, Ella! Alright, let's do this. Alright, Amanda, that's fine. Alright, where's my best bro, Craig? Kegstand Craig. Oh, there you are. Ah, there it is. Yeah, that baby River, he... Umbrella, Ella, A. I really am not sure this baby... I think this baby took that microdose of LSD. You know, I think Craig lined it up for himself and then the baby took it. Yeah, I know. The Maple Bay flapjacks against the Pinewood ocelots. Go flapjacks, I guess. I don't know, Kung Fu. Oh, they broke up or were divorced or something. I don't really remember. Does the baby have no soul? Edie, that's not nice. I just think it's microdosed on LSD. There's a difference. Perfect work, Mr. Banmick. Give it a shot. It's cathartic. Keep your eye on the ball. And also an eye on the bat and the outfield and the other players. Keep your eye on everything. Nice, sir. Craig's trained his team pretty well. Oh, it's his team, I understand. Ah, firm balls. You know, it's actually a very important thing to check out. Speaking as a medical professional, it's important to make sure that your balls are appropriate for the activities in which they will be used. For example, softball, despite the name, requires some firm balls. Otherwise, it'd be more like hitting a hacky sack, just bouncing it around everywhere, you know? Just have it flopping about. Yes, actually, it's true, AD. Hang on.
Assist cats. For the love of Pete, get out of there.
Hello, cats. Kegstand Craig is good with children. Whoa. Oh, that's fantastic. Yeah, Amanda, I know it happened to you one time. Oh, God. God. Craig, take your damn shirt off. I'm sure you're ripped under there. This stream's getting dirty. Bellandora, where have you been? I'm pretty sure I dropped an F-bomb in the first 10 minutes. Get out of here, assist cat. I'm pretty sure I also dropped a gotta get laid joke in the first 5.
What?
Oh, God. The girl plops down and starts crying. Oh, dear. Wow. Kegstand Craig flipping off roofs and shotgunning beers. What a badass. Right, exactly, Crosshair. So, for example, for shot put, your balls need to be hard as steel and weigh a ton. You know, they need to be like cannonballs. You want to be able to fire them out of a firearm and have it hurt. You know? Oh, God, what's happening over here? All right. Heist up. Craig's team is crushing the other team. Well, they're just toddlers, really. I don't know. Coming right for me! No! Ugh! Good work, Amanda! You saved me!
We got this.
Nice work, Amanda! Good job! It's a beautiful daughter. I love her a lot. And I'm proud of you, kiddo. Great job, everyone. Great job, you, Craig. Did a good job. Great work. It's great to see it paying off. Wow. Craig, I think I see a little something going on down here in those poofy pants of yours. I certainly don't mind it. Have I met Briar and Hazel? No. Hello. Killer play. Good job. Flapjacks? Thanks. You're twins, eh? Which one's the evil one? Hazel. Yeah, it's me. Oh.
Cats, I hear you. For God's sake.
Yeah. Do you guys ever pretend to be each other? Yeah. Wait, what? We'll talk about this later. Oh! That's not... Oh, he has twin daughters. Hey, and look, that baby's come down off his LSD high. That's good. Good work, Craig. So many children. Responsibility is a huge turn-on for the doctor-surgeon.
Cats, I swear to God.
All right. Janet. Ooh, taking the team to get pizza. Oh. Oh boy, alright, alright. Is it cool if my bro comes along? I dreamt I was a butterfly. That baby is freaking out, I agree. Hmm. Where are we going? What? It's a real place. Pizza! Oh god. It's such a... Oh, this is so uncomfortable. Oh, we have to be here at a party with my daughter and Craig and a baby. This is the worst booty call I've ever... Well, it's not the worst booty call I've ever had. Alright. Oh. Oh, whole pizzas and potato fillings. I mean, frankly, Craig, those were some of our better days and some of our better ideas. Here's to that. Cheers. Ah, pizzacos. I could never forget. Date, not booty call. Excuse me, Ballandora, I don't understand. Is there a difference? Mm-hmm. Our bodies were younger, more elastic, more able to handle the toxic waste we put inside of us. Craig, speaking of which, any toxic waste I can put inside you? What? Disgusting! Dr. Surgeon, that's horrifying. Exactly, Mr. Badmech, it's all about the balance. No, no, assist cat, oh, for fuck's sake. Pardon my French. Assist cats, I don't appreciate this. Sorry, Craig, you were saying. Oh. Gimme a pizza that. No. Ha ha ha. You could always chug a soda like you did in college with beer. That's right, we could shotgun them. I always thought the name shotgunning was very misleading. I liked to do things the old-fashioned way. Get a can of beer. Take your 12-gauge. Stand really far back. Blast the hell out of that sucker, and then suck out the remains. Delicious. Hmm. No, no, no puns. No dad puns. Put the huggy snuggy on the cat. AD, I will, but I'm certainly not. Oh, you're right, Ballandora. Sorry, you're right. It's not really a booty call if there are children having a nice pizza dinner. The thing about this assist cat, AD, is that if I go to do that, I'll be leaving the stream. And I'm not doing that. I actually thought the joke about the booty call was pretty good. My daughter tells me every day how great you are. Craig. Ooh, I'm Craig. I'm perfect in every way. I run and don't get winded. I strap a baby to me for resistance training. Oh, but he's talking about strong male role models. Who would ever have a booty call in a pizza parlor? Ballandora, you haven't lived. How old are you? 25, 48, 92, you haven't lived, Ballandora, damn it.
I don't know.
20 minutes, oh shoot, thanks Mr. Bad Mick. Better get laid fast. He holds up his fist for a fist bump, okay. He looks super uncomfortable. Smokescreen, Martha, that doesn't sound good. Uh-oh, okay, what about Bella, younger than that? Okay, Ballandora, jeez, I wasn't asking, I was just... Okay. Put the huggy snuggy on the cat and then wear it like he's wearing that baby. Ooh, oh, oh, bear, cat, you scared the heck out of me. Ooh. The emerald, fabulous. All right, folks, what are we doing? Creating diversions? Dr. Surgeon's very good at diversions. Tag teaming with my daughter? I don't know if I want to bring her into this. Smokescreen Martha. Sounds fun, but probably not so good for Craig. Let's go with diversion. Who watched Long Haul Paranormal Ice Ghost Tracker last night? What? Callum and Flint Dogburn Cemetery Hot Dog Grill. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Quality television. Oh, damn it. Yeah, they're pretty excited. No, 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 no.
Hey.
Assist cats. Still there? No, you're fine. Thanks for the invite. Martha, you might want to grab your child. Stuffing pizza into her. Tiffany, not another arcade machine, I swear. She seems nice. Takes all sorts. Tiffany, don't. A papoose for the assist cat. A papoose. I don't. AD. I don't mean this to be condescending, but think about it for a moment. What are they? Cats. What else are they? Assistants. They're not assistants. Dad puns. Alright. Sorry, oh. Craig, you were saying. Oh, phew. Dad? Hey, girls. They're very cute. These little girls are very cute. Can you help us beat our record on DDR? You could destroy our... My dad can destroy your dad in DDR. Yeah, well, Dr. Surgeon MD's got feet of gold. Feet made of wings. Winged feet. Oh. Something. Screw it. Whatever. They assist you in getting the views. Exactly, AD. That's what it is. Exactly. What's happening? You know, I don't have the Jukes anymore. The Jukes! I'm a big fan of the Jukes.
Oh.
Duty calls. All right. Yeah, you go DDR it up. Oh, boy. I feel like we might be a third wheel. Huh. Third and fifth wheel. Yeah, it's a good point, Amanda. Nice work. Want to go drop some coin on pinball? a machine that's... He DDRs with the baby? You're right! Exactly, AD. I think that baby is going to get a little bounce to it. I am a... Yes, Kung Fu, I'm really hoping to as well. You're pretty good. What? I'm just trying to pay... Oh, she's in her zen zone. Alright, nice work. He's a pinball... Casfe paints! Welcome to surgery. In this case, the surgery of my heart. Trying to repair it. Alright. You're friends with Craig, right? Oh, yeah. Hi, Janet. Ugh, trying to get that end zone with the payload. My god, Crosshair. I would never call it a payload. What am I, Dutch? Terrible. I'm sorry. I obviously don't... Oh. I saw that, Zen. And Elizabeth, if you're there. I hope he have a strong huggy snuggy. Alright, okay. Please don't lean on my thing. Excuse me. Do you know if he's, like, available? I don't know if I could say... Seriously, you're gonna make me tilt. Lady, I swear to God. Oh, no. You stone happy. What? I said I have to go over there and put pizza in my mouth so I don't say anything that hurts your feelings. Yeah, I know the emerald. This hey. Janet. Oh, hey, Craig. If we don't get out of here now, we gotta... Yeah, quick, get out of there. Okay, bye, Amanda.
Oh.
Hope you don't mind me bringing you back here, bro. Frankly, Craig, it's the baby that I mind. You have another living being on strapped to your manly chest. Every time I look at you, I see little baby eyes looking up at me. It's horrifying. Oh, God, not at all, though, I guess. River burps.
Oh.
Up for some catch. I mean... You still have a baby. God. Hmm. There's only juice boxes. Man. Yeah, Crosshair. I don't know if I like those odds. Because flip side, remember, you've got a live baby strapped to your chest. Not only are you gonna get pooped on, right? But also, you have a baby on you! How the hell are you gonna tuck and roll with a baby? Good lord. Think about the implications, man. Bunny, whatever. Maybe he can strap you to his chest. The emerald, please. I'm single. Wait, yes. keg stand Craig. Oh, yeah. Those were good times. I haven't properly hung out with Craig. I don't even know where to begin. I mean, I should ask about the kids, I suppose. I can't believe you're a father of three. Oh. Neither can I, you know. Oh. I had no idea what he wanted to do with his life. Oh, that's sweet. He thinks his kids are his life. It's really adorable. I mean, I guess nothing's going to happen on a first date, but what are you going to do? Aw, that's sweet, Doctor. So, tell me about coaching softball. Was that thrust upon you? Would you like anything thrust upon you, Craig? Ding ding. That's true, Crossfield. That's a good point. Actually, being so much like this with a baby and holding a baby in that kind of baby holder is dangerous. Who am I to critic? AD, yes. You gotta let Craig do Craig. Well, you gotta let me do Craig, but you also have to let Craig do Craig. Sorry, you were saying Craig. I'm worried there'd be a riot. Bunch of tiny children with metal bats. Yeah, that's for sure. Exactly, the emerald. See, I just... I mean, and we're friends, too. He'd understand. Right, Craig? So you run a business? Yep. Fitness gear. Ugh. can I interest you in a jock strap to go along with your jersey, sir? Ugh. How about some cleats and shin pads? Whatever. Oh. If you ever need athletic gear, I've got your back. That's not... What? Nice. It's nice out here. Quiet. Must be good to get away from the softball moms. Ugh, yeah, Janet. It's a good point, Crosser. I hadn't really considered. Sometimes Craig just... He was like that in college, too. Sometimes you'd get up and he would just say, you know, something... Without having thought about it, you know. Oh, you know, biochemistry is the future, for example. We would all just point and laugh. Because it was a philosophy class. Alright. Yikes. Sorry. Maybe he can model a speedo for you alone. The emerald, please. I'm blushing in front of the baby. Oh, yeah. What are you interested in? Peace and quiet. That hot, hot silence. My ultimate sexual fantasy is sleeping in on a Saturday. Craig, we're gonna update that fantasy. Get into the updating! Kuchunk, kuchunk. Vroom.
I don't know.
No dating time. He could probably teach you the wheelbarrow. Zen, please. Oh my. Oh, sorry, what? Oh no. No, it's... Craig, it's fine. Buddy, I hear you, alright? The moms can hit on you all they want. Girls are the top priority. Hit softballs! Don't get hit on by moms. What? You're doing a great job, Craig. You can be his pillow. Yeah, yes. I mean... I think you got this dad thing down. Oh, that's sweet. Oh! Damn it! Ouch. Oh, sorry, dude. Are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine, Craig. Craig spends a moment examining my head.
Dude!
You would be so lucky. I mean... Well... Oh my. Alright, the emerald. Calm down, alright? We're just having a nice kiss out on the softball field. I'm particularly happy that this baby is so dissatisfied. Hey, little buddy. Notsindu, welcome. Welcome. I should probably head out. You get older and life just... Well, that's a base. Yes, it is, Kung Fu Fenris. Remember that house party we went to? Well, the Emerald, I'm trying, damn it.
Yeah, low, I can tell. Oh, he's got his eyes closed. That's actually really cute. All right, assist cat, that's enough. Whoops. Oh, the cops. Oh, no. We just walked straight past him. I think we were whistling as we walked. You told them you were interested in joining. Hey, cat. That's enough. That's enough, assist cat. Longest 30 minutes of my life. Good old days. Aw. Yeah, I guess not. Let's hang soon. Okay, Craig. Glue stick in hand. Shark hunter lip sync battles. That's one of my favorite. Specifically because sharks don't have lips. The irony. It's just so ridiculous. Ah, Raphael, hello. Welcome to Dr. Certain MD. That's me in the corner. Whoa. Amanda, this is some good art. Look at this good art. Yeah, it's nice. Lots of dogs. Giant pile of cash. The whole thing is about my goals for the future. Sit on a giant pile of money with 20 dogs and have a strong and mutually supportive relationship with my father. That's really sweet. Oh, get ready to watch it. I'm crying. You did this with your good art. Ugh. I'm crying. I'm really good at the fake cry. Don't tell my daughter. Ah, that Craig guy sure is busy, if you know what I mean. For fuck's sake, assist cat, must you? Get out of here. Yeah, you're just knocking things over. She knocked one of my medical trophies down. And I do mean one for getting an award, not, you know, an organ I keep in a jar. That would be a disaster. Oh, yeah, sorry, Amanda, you were saying. How does it feel to face your fears? Yeah. Whoa. Parallel parking. Baby steps. All right. I'll let them know you said hey. Perfect. Hey, how did I do on my date? That's a lot of dad points. How am I doing?
Performance for sure.
S for sexy. S for super. S for surgeon. Dr. Surgeon MD. I think I did very well. The thing is, I don't have all of these things here on the sides. I don't really understand what it means. But yes, S for surgeon. Craig. Yes, work.
Welcome.
Excellent.
You've got dads.
You've got dads. I do have dads. Hello? Assist cats? Just think there's a ghost in the house. Hot daddy detected. Oh, which one, Raph? Do you mean me? You might mean me, I'm not actually sure. Yes, the emerald. I did know that. And it, frankly, you know, all euphemism aside, an orgasm is actually a fantastic way to relieve stress. Indeed. It's very important. Oh, yeah. Oh, right. Good, Crosshair. Good. I'm glad to hear it. My friends, my interns, my love turns, thank you so much for joining me today, Dr. Surgeon MD. Did we get freaky? No. Did we get strange? No. Did we throw rocks at cars, play softball with babies, and go to concert and get run over by punk children? Yes, yes, and holy crap, my knee, yes. The emerald is still on the sex thing. Good for you, emerald, keep it up. I agree, Crosshair. I should be on the internet all the time. Ooh, my tie has come a little loose, probably from all the sweating. Because I'm excited. No. You know what? Never mind. So I had a good time. No excitement, no laying, though. What are you going to do? But perhaps next week, I can get one of them to take off their shirt. That should titillate somebody. Ah, Dr. Surgeon MD. Back in business. Yes, yes. Holy crap, my knee. Yes, did you see what I did there? Because I got... It's all good. Tomorrow... I believe Zen Robo will be streaming. Sunday, it's Changeling Mother Effers. Mother Phase, Monday, 4 p.m. EDT, join me again, right here, for some Dr. Surgeon MD Dream Daddy. Just in time to say goodbye. Eriqwen, were you unavailable because of your game? I'm sorry. You missed some sweet dad-on-dad action. Not physically. Just romantically. It was nice. Tried a date with... Well, the date with Damien was... the date with Matt could have gone better. The date with Robert was good, but it's Robert. The date with Craig was good. A super surgeon, even, but... It's not really my... I'll watch the CCTV coverage. Eriqwen, please. What? Whoa, it's a cat! Whoa, there she is! Ripley! Ripley! Look up here! Wow! Oh, the light's hurting her little eyes. Oh! The emerald! Excellent. Good, because I wanted to kill another couple minutes here. Lots of cats, lots of potential Ds, no lays, groundwork is done. Exactly, Crosshair! That's the important thing about life, romance, and surgery. Get messy! Do some harm in order to do no harm. And always lay the groundwork. You must build on something. Otherwise, you must you assist, Cat? Must you? Must you right now? I was in the middle of explaining something important. Yeah, go step on my soundboard. That's a great idea. You must lay the groundwork in love as you do in surgery. Do you just jump in, shove your hand inside the patient and pull something out, ripping it out? Probably not, but sometimes yes. But probably not. Usually, you start small. You make an incision. You wash your hands first. You put on your gloves. I don't, but some people do. You get your nurses, whatever. It's very important. The emerald. Good luck for Wednesday's anatomy test. If you have any questions about human anatomy, please call me. You can reach me at 1-888-ANATOMY. Oh, doctor, you sly son of a gun. But seriously, if you have any questions about anatomy, let me know. The oculus. Sometimes in school we learn a little song to help us remember. I like to remember with my own little song. When you cut open the chest and you rip the ribs, then you see the guts and you put your hands in and you pull out small intestine, large intestine, heart, liver, lung, 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 lung. Why's he got four lungs? Hey! That was a pretty damn good song, if I do say so myself. Oh. Oh. I had a fabulous night. Love turns, you are beautiful, and you make me who I am. The doctor surgeon, I mean, well, I am who I am, but you make me the fun version of who I am instead of the mean, cruel one who just wants to watch television with my daughter. I swear to God, I am going to wrap you up in shirt. It's not really a threat, they don't. Yes, Rock Pants. I am pleased as well. Thank you all so much for joining me. I will leave you with a black screen and some Aerosmith. TTFN, Sweater Girl! 1950s reference, I hope somebody gets it. Don't forget, keep calm, make tea, do some harm in order to do no harm, lay some groundwork, and don't forget to get messy. That is a euphemism.